But let's address the elephant in the room. Frankly
Yes.
speaking, it's the president who's the agriculture secretary. So
Yes.
you have lawmakers hitting on the agriculture undersecretary, Domingo
Right.
Maniban. But if this were another administration, we would all be asking the
Yeah.
agriculture secretary, why is this happening? This is
Right.
the purview of the agriculture secretary.
It
But
is.
nobody can seem to question the president.
But you know, the actors in this crime have already dragged him, even visually, into this
Why
investigation.
is it dragged him? Is
Kasi,
it responsible as the secretary?
Indeed, he is the concurrent agriculture secretary while also the president. And there's a photo, Karen. May picture pa nga si presidente. Kasama itong tatlong smugglers at si DA Senior Yusek Panganiban. Eh, mapapatanong ka na naman, baka naman yung letratong yan sa meeting nila noong January 25, ang tunay na sugar order? Kasi, okay, January 25 ang kudakan at pagkatapos may supply na ng February 9. So parang mas tama yung timeline nun. Dumating ang asukal bago pa man maaprubahan at ma-publish yung SO6. So yan na ba yung kalakaran ng Malacanang at ng apuradong kartel? At sa loob ng 2 buwan, nagplansya ng gusot ang SRA. Ha? Mula sa mga dagdag na memo, patong-patong na clearances, pabaliktad na pagbasa ng kalendaryo. I showed you the scrambled egg timeline. Ginawa ang lahat para lang mailabas ang puslit na supply. Walang duda na pilit nilang tinutuwid ang baluktot. And so Karen, this is legal cover-up at its finest or its grossest.
Yeah, and would this have the go signal of the president if you have no less than the executive secretary, as you said, also giving out the, you said the memo.
The memo, yes.
Yeah. Because the executive secretary won't be acting. That's the right hand of the president. That's the little president.
That's right.
Former justice, but why would Justice Bersamian
do? Yes, Chief Justice.
Yeah, why would he do that, right? Unless the president knew about it.
That's what we need to ask and hear from the ES and possibly even from the president. Kasi yung sinasite ni Yusek Panganiban na de facto basis niya para sa kanyang de facto sugar order ay itong memo na mula kay ES. Eh hindi naman, of course Karen, hindi naman illegal no, yung pagbibigay ng memo. Ginagawa talaga yan. Pero yung memo, dapat ding may legal basis. And yung legal basis para sa issue na ito ay yung paulit-ulit ko nangang sinasabi. Kailangan ng sugar order bago makapag-angkat. An SO is quite simply a requirement under the law. I shouldn't need to tell this to the ES. At syempre, si Presidente din, siya ang pinakamataas sa aming mga nagtatrabaho sa gobyerno. Eh, dapat alam din nila ito. At masagot sana, at least ng office of the ES. What Yusek Panganiban did, according to him, on the strength of the memo of ES, he effectively bypassed the legal mandate of the SRA. So other government agencies have followed suit, Karen, in these bad examples. Yung Bureau of Customs, eh hindi rin pala naghahanap ng sugar order. Basta na lang nila tinanggap yung clearance ng SRA, kahit pa, klaro naman, smuggled ang supply na dumating ng February 9. Eh, so yun na nga, bakit pa may batas kung hindi naman susundin?
Yeah, but so Senator, is it really harder, frankly, to call the agriculture secretary into account because he is the president? Because what happens is we are, I know you're calling the attention of the SRA, but this is an undersecretary.
Right.
I mean, really, at the end of the day, in another universe, we will be talking about the secretary.
Correct.
Right.
And we are
talking
about. I don't
hear senators really criticizing the agriculture secretary.
Right.
Because,
and
let's be honest, is it difficult?
Yeah.
It is the president.
In terms of balance of power, it might seem difficult to call the president. But in terms of accountability, lahat naman po kami ay nanumpa sa parehong konstitusyon. So the president is as accountable, or dahil siya ang aming primus inter pares sa buong gobyerno, We could say, in principle, siya ang pinaka-accountable. And in fact, Karen, at this late stage of this continuing crime na sinusubukan nilang i-perfect, pwede talaga akong, mananawagan ako kay Presidente. Sir, ilang smoking gun ba ang kailangan ninyo para maitama ito at para mabigyan ng hustisya ang sugar industry? And by the way, Mr. President, dagdag pa dyan, no? Nasaan na ang ipinagmamalaki nilang supply na ibibigay di umano sa kadiwa? Ha? Oh, hindi naman kasali pala doon yung asukal ng mga paboritong importers na All Asian, Edison Lee Marketing at saka Sukden Philippines. Eh naging isang malaking paasa lang pala yung kadiwa na yan. And simula pa lang, Karen, sinabi ko dapat ibigay yan ng libre sa tao, huwag ibenta. Tapos ngayon pa lang ang ending, wala rin palang darating ni isang kilo sa kadiwa. So over and over again, the president's name and position is dragged into this issue from beginning up to the sorry end that we are seeing. Kailan pa ba sila mag-step in dito at iwawas to?
Senator, should he already really just appoint a full-time agriculture secretary?
Yes.
I know you've called for this before, but when and the president has laid out when he believes it's the right time, right? Mm-hmm. But has that time come?
That
when
time
should
has
that time be, yeah.
That time has long passed, Karen. It should have been at the start of the administration dahil tulad ng health, yung agrikultura ay isang bahagi ng ating paggugobyerno na nasa crisis since the previous administration. And now, with these unrelenting crimes and attempted crimes in the agricultural sector, dagdag sa pabigat ng ating mga magsasaka at mangingisda and other rural sectors, at dagdag sa pabigat ng ating mga consumers na hindi na halos abot kaya ang presyo ng mga pagkain. Well, the time is long past to appoint an full-time agricultural secretary to address these issues, to prevent and to make accountable those accountable for such crimes, and you know, to look at the long-term agricultural development agenda that our country has long been asking for, but not ever to sweep under the rug yung ganitong mga krimen at attempted crimes tulad ng agricultural smuggling, itong pagbibigay sa tatlong kumpanya lang dati, at least 10, madalas mga tens of importers, 30 importers per sugar order. Tatlong kumpanya lang sa 450,000 metric tons. And sa suma, hindi naman bumaba ang presyo ng asukal sa 65 pesos. Ha?
And I'm curious, Senator, based on your research, are you seeing, I mean, these three companies, what you call these three favored sugar importers,
they are.
Are you seeing a connection with Malacañang or... what's special about the three? Have you already covered this?
We're really looking into that. Bakit nga sila special? Hindi sila regular tulad ng tens of other importers that historically have been given awards of allocation, excuse me, under previous sugar orders. They're so special na kapag meeting sila at letrato kay presidente sa Malacañang mismo. And what's so special about them, considering that one of them has a history of smuggling, another of them ay di umanong undercapitalized, sabi ko nga para siyang formally sa isang para siyang para siyang formally doon sa investigasyon namin sa pandemic supplies, itong isa naman sa sugar smuggling undercapitalized pero pinaboran in a previous sugar order, hindi siya nabigyan ng anumang allocation by other importers. So kumbaga kahit sa peers nila sa industriya, walang confidence sa kanila. And yung mataas na presyo na maaasahan kapag walang pwedeng lapitan kundi ang iilang kumorna ng supply, that's what these three are examples of. At gusto nilang i-cartelize ito, Karen. They are putting up a new sugar cartel. They are probably looking forward to establishing a new sugar monopoly. So what are we waiting for?
You have not seen, is there a connection between, I mean, among the three to the president himself? Has that come out in your investigation?
That's what we should ask and find out in the investigation. Kasi nga, I haven't heard of previous sugar importers sa ilalim ng mga naunang sugar orders. Marami na yon, Karen, na nakapagletrato at meeting kay Presidente sa Malacanang. So really, maitatanong, what's so special about these three na hindi naman nila deserve? Kumbaga, kung yung isa ay dati ng smuggler, yung isa ay undercapitalized, siguro naman may mas marami pang sugar importers dyan na all these years sumunod sa tawag nito yung batas na nag-regulate sa SRA. Siguro naman maraming ibang importers na sumusunod sa iba pang mga batas natin, at dahil sa importation nila in those times na ibaba ang presyo ng asukal. So really, why did these three get the line in front of them? Bakit yung tatlo isinara na yung pila kahit sa iba?
Okay. All right. Moving on just very quickly before I want to touch on divorce just a little. There's already been a change. I know that the president has announced that the National Food Authority will no longer import rice for its buffer stock, but buy from the local farmers, which, honestly speaking, is the right thing. Wasn't that really the mandate of the NFA to begin with?
That's right, Karen. And even in looking at our agricultural crisis, we really need always to look at support for our rice farmers, pagpapataas ng farm gate prices nila, suporta sa kanila sa simula ng agricultural process in terms of subsidies para sa kanilang mga inputs, at sa dulo naman ng proseso pag-provide, halimbawa yung pinanawagan namin dun sa krisis sa sibuyas, no, yung cold storage facilities, yung irrigation systems. Pero ito namang sa buffer stock, meron din kailangang sundin ng mga rules ng National Food Authority. Kailangan strategic din yung location ng mga buffer stocks na iyan. At hindi lang isang nationwide na utos ni Presidente tungkol dyan.
Okay. Actually, you are questioning, you are asking the economic managers to justify why we need to increase the buffer stock. This is
right.
Yeah. But yes. But shouldn't it really be increased? Am I correct to say the buffer stock right now, is it like 9 days?
It has to be studied whether the buffer stock has to be increased beyond 9 days. Kaya nga't iniintay natin at kaagad na mag-weigh in dyan ang NEDA, maabisuhan, magabayan nila ang NFA so that can be carried out properly. Laging evidence-based palagi dapat, Karen, kami sa policy making, at sila rin ang ating executive sa kanilang mga desisyon tungkol sa ganitong mga programa.
Okay, my last question is the divorce bill. It's in last Women's Month, it was quite interesting that you are still pushing for the divorce bill. I wanted to ask you, what kind of, why are you optimistic that after all these years, you have Filipinos allergic to the word divorce? Also, given our, the landscape of that majority of Filipinos are Catholic, you have lawmakers that won't touch the word divorce. How are you seeing? Are you seeing something different now?
Yes, I'm seeing
something different.
I'm seeing something different, Karen. Kahit yung latest, kahit mga 2018 pa iyon, pero survey ng SWS bago ng pandemya tungkol sa divorce, nagpakita na may mayorya nating mga Pilipino na pumapabor dito, 57 or 53%, a clear majority. Tapos muli, I think it for the second Congress in a row, naaprubahan na ng House of Representatives on third and final reading ang kanilang version ng kanilang dissolution of marriage or divorce bill. At kami rin po sa Senado, pangalawang beses na natapos namin yung hearing tungkol doon, magte-technical working group para maglabas muli ng isang committee report. Kami yung kailangan mag-catch up ulit sa House, at kami sa Kongreso kailangan mag-catch up sa ating mga mamamayan.
And are you calling this the divorce bill or the dissolution of marriage bill?
Well, my own bill, Karen, and please note there are 8 bills in the Senate this Congress from 6 of us senators. My own bill is called Dissolution of Marriage Bill. But in effect, it is a divorce bill.
Although you're thinking it's more acceptable, right? It's more palatable. The word dissolution.
Well, a rose by any other name is just as sweet. Yeah. And ang magiging epekto naman niya ay divorce. And the way we are, understanding and still presenting these bills to our colleagues, to the public, ay itong divorce bill ay totoong pro-marriage, pro-family, pro-women, and pro-children bill. At ito ay magbibigay ng second chance at life and love sa maraming kababayan natin.
Mm-hmm. All right. On that note, I do hope to have you on the show again to talk about that.
Gladly, Karen.
Senator Ontiveros, have a good weekend, ma'am. You take care.
Weekend, Karen. Ingat.